Good morning! And it's another beautiful day in the Philippines. And I'm up early again. Today we are on quite a trip. Now, one of the things with the Philippines that puts a lot of people off coming is that it's made of lots of islands. We shouldn't put a lot of people off coming because all these islands are beautiful, but it's getting between the islands that sometimes can be a task, and getting information can sometimes be difficult. Because today I'm going from Siargao to Bohol, and I'm not just getting on, you know, like a plane and go from one place to another. Today, my trip starts with a motorbike that I've rented that I have to return. When I get there, I'm getting on a minibus to the airport. Then I'm going to take an hour flight from Siargao to Cebu Mactan Airport. Then I'm going to get a taxi from the airport to the port. Then I'm going to get a boat from Cebu Pier 1 to Tagbilaran, which is on the island of Bohol. Then I'm going to get a trike from Tagbilaran to Alona, where I'm staying. It's 6 a.m, and I'm already tired with the thought of that journey. But let's go to Bohol. Siargao Airport. So far we've had a motorbike ride, minibus, now at the airport, waiting for our plane. And Siargao is a very small airport. There's actually only gate 1, gate 2. And gate 3, according to the sign, appears to be in the shop over there. But there's only a couple of airlines fly here. Cebu Pacific, PAL, that's Philippine Airlines, and also Skyjet. So, let's wait for my plane. Maybe find some breakfast snacks. Cebu. Just about 20 past 10. Past 10? And past 10. Half 10, so a very short flight. It was very nice and easy, beautiful flight over some amazing scenery, looking down at those little islands with beaches. You wonder if anybody lives there or has gone there. But now I've got to go and find a taxi to get to the port. Come on, let's go. It's 10, half past 10 now. My boat leaves at 1 o'clock. And now Mactan Airport is on a little island actually beside Cebu City, so I've got to get from the island across the bridge, after I get a taxi that is, then to the pier, then to check in. So I should have plenty of time, but the traffic can get quite tricky. So I can see the white taxis, and there's plenty of taxis and not too long a queue, so I should get a taxi quickly, and let's hope that the traffic isn't too bad. Here we go. No queue of people, but there was a queue of taxis waiting, so I got on the taxi straight away, which is great. One of the advantages of travelling with only hand luggage, you don't have to wait for your baggage to come out, and you can sometimes get ahead of the queues, which is really nice. So I've got my white taxi, off to Pier 1, let's see how the traffic is, and it's a nice sunny day. I can't believe I'm travelling between places, I'm going to be inside boats and planes and cars and buses and taxis, and I have a sunny day. Where was this sunny day yesterday when I was on a motorbike on a muddy hill on the side of Siargao? I'll enjoy the sunshine wherever I get it. And I'll enjoy everywhere I go, even if it rains. Because I had great fun in Siargao. Even though it was a lot of wet and grey weather, with some patches of sun, it's a brilliant place to visit. The surfing, the Mapaponko pools, the island life, it's really beautiful. Now, we're off to another island. Assuming I get to the pier in time. Thank you very much, sir. Oh! Welcome to Robinson's Galleria. Okay, so, got my taxi, and just near the port, there's a new mall called Robinson's Galleria, and since it's only 11 o'clock, I've got 2 hours to my boat, and I haven't had either breakfast or lunch, I got the taxi, dropped me off here, where I shall now select from the massive selection of food places, and have some lunch before getting another taxi the little short way down to the boat, because I think it's only about 10-15 minutes to Pier 1 from here, so I've got an hour to eat and chill in an aircon mall. Then got the taxi and Pier 1. Okay, so after having a little snack at Robinson's Galleria, some coffee and a sausage roll, and then took another taxi, which is just literally 7 minutes down the road to Terminal 1 or Pier 1, where I've got to check in and get my boat to Tagbalaran, which should be 2 hours. I've got 30 minutes to spare, so let's go and get on the boat. Let's get in there. Ticket, got my port fee, went through security, then you go to the counter and get your seat, and now, literally, it's boarding. I get on the boat, which is just here, gate 8. Thank you. In the Philippines. Now when you're on the boat, if you got some bags,
They all pile at the front like this because you're not allowed to have baggage in the aisleways. Whoa, come on camera, sorry. Okay, you're not allowed to have bags in the aisles. So you either put them in the seat or you dump them at the front, there.
Things more fun.
Of Tagbilaran. You can also fly here from Cebu, but I took the fast craft boat. It was, I think, 500 pesos for the tourist class, which is aircon inside. There's also a business class and a deck class. I think deck was 300, business 700. Has bigger seats or something. Anyway, nice, easy. I think under 2 hour journey, or maybe 2 hours, arrived at the port of Tagbilaran. Now when you get out, there's obviously people, taxis, buses, trikes all waiting. And or if you've organized a lift, they wait for you at the exit. But I'm taking a trike to Alona Beach, which is quite a drive down. But the trikes in the airport are actually at a set price, which is a bit higher than the standard price. So what you can do if you want to save a little bit of money is do what I'm doing. I'm walking out of the port complex with my bags, which in this heat is obviously a bit tiring, but there you go. I'm going to go out of the complex to the main road because the town is just up here. Port's behind me. Takes about 10 minutes walk. And I'll walk up and I'll get a trike from the city to take me to Lona Beach. It'll be about half the price that it will be picking it up in the port. So come on. Part of the journey to Pangloan de Bohol is in a trike. Now these are like the traditional short haul taxis around Bohol and a lot of parts of the Philippines. Now realistically I would say they're going to take 2 passengers and bags, but often they cram quite a few people in here. But of course I just have one to myself. Now I think the usual fare from the airport or the port where I came in is 300 pesos. I've managed to get to it for 250 because it's quite a drive down to Panglao, as you'll see. Tagbilaran has not really got much beach. Really, Tagbilaran, you only go because there's a port and the airport there. You want to get away from that, go down to Panglao Island, which is on the south of Bohol, and head towards the Alona Beach area, which is a nice area to situate yourself, which is where we are going right now. And that was a trike, the final transportation on my journey from Siargao Island to Panglao Island on Bohol. So we started off with the rental motorbike, which we then drove and dropped off. Then we got the minibus to the airport. Then we took the plane to Cebu. Then we took a taxi to the port. Then a boat to Tagbilaran. Then a trike to Panglao and Alona. And now, we arrived. Lovely swimming pool. I'll be splunging in that later to cool off. First, let's go check out the room, which is here, ground floor room. So, stairs to climb, got a nice little balcony. Oh, wow, that's nice. Look at that. Oh, it's nice and cool in here as well. Yeah, nice bed, aircon, TV, fridge, and there's the aircon, the TV and a fridge, a little desk, there's the bathroom,
listen. Toilet, basin, and a shower. That's looking nice. I'm gonna be very comfortable my stay here, eh? Look at that. Oh, alone a pangolin.